Hello community, it's been a while since my last video, but here we are replacing a power tool battery case from a Snap-on micro lithium family of tools and see what brand sells is this made of. Let's get started. Okay, we're replacing the enclosure because the tabs that hold the battery and the tools broke off due to usage and fatigue. As you can see here, this one is a model CTB7172 lithium battery, and this is the battery we will take apart and replace it. With this enclosure, I bought on eBay as an original Snap-on replacement case. As can be seen here, it has all the proper markings as the original has, except for date of manufacture. The good thing about these kind of batteries is that they are not glued together, which makes them perfect for repair. Let's continue here. Before taking it apart, how these batteries provide a dual voltage is that they are split into two segments, or they are built in parallels. And the tool is configured in such a way that it, depending on this case, the tool, it will use 7.2 volts or 14.4 volts, depending on how the tool is configured to use the voltage. Let's go ahead and take it apart. This battery was manufactured in 2013 and stamped on the case. Construction is very simple. The material for this plastic black part is reinforced nylon. And the bottom part is a molded rubber and plastic case. As some of you may know, lithium batteries come with different color wraps depending on the manufacturer. This one is a light blue color. Normally, this is for a Samsung branded battery. Also, we can see the circuitry for the dual voltage of the battery pack. So the combination would be these two contacts here for the 7.2 volts and these other two contacts for 14.4 volts. And I think what the tools does is that when it needs the 14.4 volts, the circuitry in the tool is in such a way that instead of using parallel voltage, it combines them to make them in series. These are Samsung branded cells, model INR 18650-15M. And these are 1.5 amp hours, 23 amp cells. It would be nice to replace these with higher amp hour cells for longer duration, but the next model of this battery, which has the highest amount of amp hours, which is the INR 18650-25R, has lower discharge current capacity. Now let's go ahead and remove the battery from the bottom part of the enclosure, and hopefully I won't break the wrapping on this, because sometimes they use a very strong glue, just that the battery itself is not moving around inside. We have the batteries removed. As I suspected, wrapping damage happened. It's interesting to see that they only place glue on the edges. But now I'll need to find a way to fix this tear up of the wrapping, because I don't want to have that metal exposed. What I think I'm going to do is just wrap the part that got damaged with captain tape. I don't think it's going to do any harm in doing that, because the batteries are separated with those, with these black separators, and it's not going to be worth separating each cell just to replace the wrapping. I could damage the battery pack doing so. So I think that's the route I'm going to take. Okay, let me get the captain tape and wrap it up with that one. I know it's not the safest to do, because moisture could still get in, and of course the life of the battery is going to be diminished because of possible rust issues. But it's a risk I'm willing to take. Not that I'm saying that everyone should do it that same way, but it's a solution worth trying. Okay, and here we have it. It's complete. Looks new. It's once again, at least the case, that is. And could I just replace the bottom part with the new part? Of course I could. But I've tried cleaning this red casing, and truly, I prefer to replace the whole thing. That one was hard to clean, probably with alcohol or a little bit of degreaser or hand cleaner, but no, I just prefer to do a little bit more work and replace the whole thing. Now that we have a used like new battery pack, I will put on the charger and later back to work. Hope this has been helpful, interesting, or at least entertaining. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Leave a comment if you liked it. And if you want to see more like it, stay tuned for more. Until next time.